Welcome back, children. Today we'll do some more questions from the arithmetic progression. With today's class, we'll wind up the lesson arithmetic progression. Okay. Now, first question. The first term of an AP is 5. The last term is 45, and the sum is 400. Find the number of terms and the common difference. Okay, see what is given here. First term of an AP is 5. That means A equal to 5. Last term is denoted as AN. So last term is equal to 45. And sum that is SN. It is denoted by SN. That is equal to 400. It is asked to find out the number of terms N and the common difference D. So let us start with AN. That is AN equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Okay, we know that it is given as 45. So A, it is given 5. 5 plus N minus 1 into D equal to 45. N minus 1 into D equal to 45 minus 5, n minus 1 into d equal to 40. So let it be there. Equation number 1. Here n is unknown and d is also unknown. Now we take the next formula, that is Sn. So we consider Sn. We know Sn equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, or we know here first term and the last term. So we can make use the other formula, that is n by 2 into first term plus the last term. So Sn we know it is 400, n by 2 into first term is 5, last term is 45. So 400 equal to n by 2 into 50. 400 equal to n into 50 by 2 is 25. So n equal to 400 by 25, that is equal to 16. N equal to 16. Now you can put this value in equation number 1 and solve for D. So let us see. Putting n equal to 16 in equation number 1, we have n minus 1 into d equal to 40. That is 16 minus 1 into d equal to 40, or 15d equal to 40, and d is 40 by 15, that is equal to 8 by 3. So we got the number of terms as 16 and the common difference is 8 by 3. Okay, look at the second question. The first term and the last term of an AP are 17 and 350 respectively. If the common difference is 9, how many terms are they and what is their sum? So it is given here, first term and last term are 17 and 350. So what is A? A equal to 17. Last term we take it as AN. AN equal to 350, and it is given that common difference is 9. So common difference is denoted as D. So D equal to 9. It is asked to find out how many terms are there. That means number of terms, how much, and what is their sum. That is Sn is equal to what? What is N and what is Sn? So now what is it given? A is given, AN is given. So we start with the AN. AN equal to 350. That is A plus N minus 1 into D equal to 350. A we can give 17. N is not known. So N minus 1 into 9. D is 9. So 350. Now N minus 1 into 9 is 350 minus 17. So n minus 1 is 350 minus 17 is 333. Now n minus 1 is 333 divided by 9. So n minus 1 is 38. So number of terms equal to 38. Now we have to find Sn. Sn means S38. Okay. We have Sn equal to n by 2 into a plus an. We use this formula because a is given and an is also given. So if this n 38 by 2 into 17 plus 350, that is 19 into 367. 19 into 367 is, if you multiply it, 73. 19 into 367. Okay. Now in this question, find the sum of first 22 terms of an AP. It's given that B equal to 7 and 22nd term is 149. So we have to find the sum of first 22 terms, means S22 we have to find out. And it's given that D equal to 7. 22nd term means A22 equal to 149. What is S22? So we start with the A22. Okay. So we have A22 equal to A plus 21D. That is A plus 21D equal to 149. A plus 21D equal to 149. That is A we don't know. So A plus 21 into 7 equal to 149. A equal to 149 minus 147. 21 into 7 is 147. So A equal to 2. If you have A and D and the number of terms, you will get S22. That is, we can use the formula Sn equal to n by 2 into first term plus the last term, because this asks to find out S22. So n is now 22. 22 by 2 into a is, a we got now as 2. 2 plus an means it is A22. That is 149. Now 11 into 151. 11 into 151 is 1661. So S22 is, sum of 22nd term is 1661. Next question is, find the sum of first 51 terms of an AP whose second and third term are 14 and 18 respectively. So second term means we denote it as A2. Second term is given. What is second term? Second term is 14 and the third term is 18. So second term is 14. That means A plus B equal to 14. And A3, third term is 18, that is A plus 2D equal to 18. Now if you solve both the equation, you can see what is D. You will get D. If you get D, you can substitute in any of the equation, you will get A. If you get A and D, you can find out the sum of 51 terms, because here it is given N equal to D1. Okay. Now let us solve this. Subtracting equation 1 and 2. 1 minus 2 we get minus D. A minus A becomes 0. D minus 2D is minus D equal to minus 4, or D equal to 4. And from the question we will get what is N. N is equal to 51. Now putting D equal to 4 in equation 1, we get A plus 4 equal to 14. A equal to 14 minus 4, that is 10. A equal to 10. So we got A equal to 10 now, D equal to 4, and it is given that N equal to 51 in the question. Now SN, SN equal to N by 2 into, we don't know AN. So it's, you can find out AN and then use the other formula. Otherwise 2A plus N minus 1 into D, that is 51 by 2 into 2 into 10 plus 51 minus 1 into D is 4. Now SN equal to, or S51 equal to, S51 equal to 51 by 2 into 20 plus 50 into 4. So it is 51 into 110, we will get 5610. So is 51 equal to 5610. Now the next question is, if the sum of first 7 terms of an AP is 49 and that of 17 term is 289. The sum of first 7 terms means S7. S7 is equal to 49 and sum of 17 terms means it is S17 equal to 289. It is asked to find the sum of first N terms. So SN. Sum of 7 terms means S7. S7 is 49. 17 terms, that is S17, 289. It is asked to find out the sum of N terms, SN. S7 equal to 7 by 2 into 2A plus 7 minus 1 into D. That is 7 by 2 into 2A plus 6D equal to, it is given as 49. Okay. Now SN by 2 into, from this we take out 2 common, 2 outside, A plus 3D equal to 49. 2 getting cancels, we get A plus 3D equal to 49 divided by 7. So A plus 3D equal to 7, equation number 1. Now we take the next condition, that is S17. Now S17 is N by 2 into 2A plus 17 minus 1 into D, that is equal to 289. Now 17 by 2 into 2A plus 16D equal to 289. Now 17 by 2 into, what is common? 2 is common, A plus 8D equal to 289. 2 getting cancels, we get 17 into A plus 8D equal to 289. A plus 8D is 289 by 17, so that A plus 8D equal to 17. 289 divided by 17 is 17. First equation is A plus 3D equal to 7. Second equation is A plus 8D equal to 17. If you get solve this, you will get D. Then you can find the A. Now subtract the equations. 3D minus 8D is negative 5D. 7 minus 17 is negative 10. D equal to negative 10 by negative 5. That is equal to, putting D equal to 2 in equation 1. We have the equation 1 as A plus 3D equal to 7. So A plus 3 into 2 equal to 7, A equal to 7 minus 3 into 2, 6, 7 minus 6, A equal to 1. So we have A equal to 1 and D equal to 2. It is asked again to find the sum of N terms, that is SN. N equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. N by 2 into 2 into A is 1, and n minus 1 into d. D equal to 2 we get. Now n by 2 into 2 plus, removing the bracket we get 2n minus 2. 2 into n and 2 into minus 1. That is n by 2 into 2 getting cancels. 2n, again 2 is getting cancels. We get n square, that is sum of n terms of this AP equal to n square. Next one, show that a1, a2, a3, etc. an form an AP where an is defined as an equal to 3 plus 4n. Also find the sum of first 15 terms. First we have to see that whether the sequence of this form, form an AP. So we have an equal to 3 plus 4n. If you give n as 1, you will get the first term. If you give n as 2, we will get the second term, and so on. So putting n is equal to 1, we get a1 equal to 3 plus 4 into 1. So a1 equal to 3 plus 4 is 7. Now n equal to 2, we get second term, that is 3 plus 4 into 2. Second term is 3 plus 8, that is 11. Now n equal to 3, we get a3. a3 is 3 plus 4 into 3. 3 plus 12, that is equal to 15. So a1 equal to 7, a2 equal to 11, a3 equal to 15. 7, 15 and 15, etc. Check whether it form an AP. Yes, 11 minus 7, it is 4. 15 minus 11, it is also 4. So it form an AP with the first term as 7 and the common difference as 4. To find S15. So S15 equal to, we use the formula n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So S15. N by 2 into 2 into a. A is 7. 2a plus n minus 1 into 4. That is 15 by 2 into 14 plus, 15 minus 1 is 14. 14 into 4. 15 by 2 into 14 plus 56. That is 15 by 2 into 70. 15 into 25. Next one, if the sum of the first n terms of an AP is 4n minus n square, that is Sn equal to 4n minus n square, what is the first term? S1. What is the sum of first two terms? Sum of first two terms means S2. Sum of the first term, that is S1, that is only one term means, that is S1 or what is the sum of first two terms, that is S2. What is the second term? Second term is A2. Similarly, find the third, tenth and nth term. Now, Sn is given. Sn equal to 4n minus n square. If you give n as 1, putting n equal to 1, we get S1. 4 minus 1, S1 equal to 3. S1 equal to 3 means sum of one term. Sum of one term means it is A1. First term is equal to 3. S1 means here, that is the first term of this AP. Now, what is the sum of first two terms that we get when we put n equal to 2? That is S2. 4 into 2 minus 2 square. 8 minus 4. So S2 equal to 4. What is S2 equal to 4 means sum of first two terms. That is A1 plus A2 equal to 4. Now we got the first term is 3 and the sum of first two terms is equal to 4. Then what is the second term? Yes, we get second term A2 as 4 minus first term. 4 minus first term we got it as 3. So 4 minus 3, 1. So the second term is equal to 1. Now similarly find the third term. Third term how will you find? If you know first term and the second term, we can find out a common difference. Okay, common difference is second term minus first term. Second term 1 minus 3, that is equal to negative 2. So we can find A3. A3 equal to A plus 2D. A is 3. 3 plus 2 into negative 2. 3 minus 4, that is negative 1. That is third term is negative 1. Now A10. A10 is A plus 9D. A is 3. 9 into negative 2. 3 plus negative 18. That is negative 15. So A10 equal to negative 15. An. Nth term means it is An. An equal to A plus minus 1 into D. A we got 3 plus n minus 1 into negative 2. 3 plus negative 2 into n. Negative 2 into negative 1 plus 2. That is equal to 3 plus 2, 5 minus 2n. So an equal to 5 minus 2n. The same question can be done like this also. That is, here we got the second term as 1. Finding the third term. You can use this also, this method also to find the third term. That is, third term can be written as, third term can be written as sum of the first three terms minus sum of the first two terms. We got already S2 here. S3 what? S3 how will you get? S3 you can find out by putting n equal to 3 in this equation. That is 4 into 3 minus 3 square. 12 minus 9 equal to 3. Now A3 equal to S3 minus S2 4. S2 4. That is equal to negative 1. Now the same way here it is asked to find out 10th term. How to find a 10th term? 10th term is sum of 10 terms minus sum of 9 terms. So you have to find out what is S10. S10 equal to, put n equal to 10 in equation number 1. 4 into 10 minus 10 square, 40 minus 100, that is negative 60. S9, S9 is 4 into 9 minus 9 square, 36 minus 81, that is negative 45. Now A10, A10 equal to negative 60 minus 45, that is negative 60 plus 45, that is equal to negative 15. We got the same answer earlier also. Now here we have, we can use the for this method also to find out the nth term of this AP. We have Sn equal to 4n minus n square. Now we have seen that A3, the third term is sum of the three terms minus sum of two terms. And the tenth term is sum of 10 terms minus sum of 9 terms. Now we can generalize it as nth term is sum of n terms minus sum of n minus 1 term. So Sn minus 1 we have to find it by substituting n as n minus 1. We get in this method 4n minus 4 equal to removing the bracket, that is expanding and using a minus b whole square. That rearranging the terms we get it as 6n minus n square minus 5. Now we have an equal to sn minus 1. Now sn we substitute the same thing minus sn minus 1 we got this one. is n minus 1. So substitute that, removing the bracket, cancelling the terms, we get 5 minus 2n. The same answer we got in using the other step also. So in this case, the other method will be easy. Okay, if you want, only you just write it, otherwise leave it. But generally we can say that ak is, suppose if you want to find the kth term of an ap, that is sum of k terms minus sum of k minus 1 term. an equal to sn minus 1, or ak equal to sk minus 1. You can just remember this formula, because this will be helping you to you attend the MCQ questions. Okay. Find the sum of the first 40 positive integers divisible by 6. Sum of 40 positive integers. So the number which is divisible by 6, that means the all the multiples of 6 you can consider. All the multiples of 6 will be divisible by 6. So let us start with the first number is 6. Then comes 12, 18, etc. Then you can see what is the last number. First 40 positive integers. So 40 into 6 is 240. So this is the AP here. 6, 12, 18, etc. 240. Now we get A equal to 6. D is 12 minus 6, 6. And AN equal to 240. It is asked to find SN equal to n by 2 into a plus an, that is s 40 by 2 into 6 plus 240, 20 into 246, it is 4920. Okay, next one, find the sum of the odd numbers between 0 and 50. Odd numbers. So, which is the odd number just after 0? Okay. For first odd number is 1. Okay. 1. Then what is the other odd number? 1 plus 2, it is 3. So, 1, 3, 5, etc. Last odd number, that is just below 50, that is 49. So, 1, 3, 5, etc. 49 are the odd numbers. It is asked to find out the sum. How many odd numbers are there from 0 to, or between 0 and 50? You can find using that here, an, using an. So we have as 1, common difference is 2, and an is equal to 49. So from this we can find number of terms. Number of terms is an minus a1 divided by d plus 1. So 49 minus 1 by 2 plus 1, 48 by 2 plus 1, 24 plus 1, that is n equal to 25. There are 25 odd numbers from between 0 and 50. Now we find S25. S25 is n by 2 into first term plus last term, that is 25 by 2 into 50. 25 into 25, that is 625. Now you can see that a sum of n odd numbers will be always n square. Here we got sum of first 25 odd numbers as 625, that is 625 is equal to 25 square. So generally we can say that sum of the first n odd numbers is n equal to n square. Sum of the first sum of the first n odd positive integer will be always n square, and sum of n first n even positive number will be n into n plus 1. You can check, that is SN, you can find in this same AP, you can find SN, you can see that it is n square. And you take, consider even number positive integers, take that AP and find SN. Okay. Here we have how many terms of an AP 24, 21, 18, etc. must be taken so that their sum is 78. We have the AP 24, 21 and 18. So from that AP you can see first term is 24. Common difference is 21 minus 24, negative 3. And what is the number of terms so that their sum is 78. That is Sn equal to 78. Then what is n? So okay, we can start with Sn. Sn equal to n by 2 into, now we have 78 equal to n by 2 into 8 into 2 equal to n into 2. We remove the bracket here. 78 into 2 equal to n into 2 into 24, 48, removing the bracket, n into minus 3, minus 3n plus minus into minus plus 3. So 78 into 2 is 156, that is n into 48 plus 3 is 51 minus 3n. So we get 156 equal to 51n minus 3n square, or taking to left side, 3n square minus 51n plus 156 equal to 0. Here it becomes a quadratic equation in n. We can solve for n. Now divide the throughout by 3, we get n square minus 17n plus 52 equal to 0. So now we can use the factorization method, that is splitting of middle term. If you factorize 52, you can see that it is, we can consider 4 and 13 as the factors. So 4 and 13, if you take sum, you can see it is 70. If you have minus 4 and minus 13, you will get sum as negative 17 and the product as 52. So you can split up like this. Taking common, here we get two values for n. N is equal to 4 or n equal to 13. That is, here in this case both the values are admissible because sum of 4 terms is equal to sum of 13 terms. Sum of 4 terms is equal to sum of 13 terms equal to 78. How it is possible both the value? Because you can see that sum of the 5th term to 13th term will be 0. Sum of the 5th term to 13th term will be 0 because we have the common difference as negative 3. You can note down sum of 4 terms equal to sum of 13 terms equal to 78 because we got common difference is negative 3. You can see that sum of 5th term to 13th term will be 0 as the common difference is negative. Hope you have understood everything. Okay.